You mean to tell me you've been tracking this character over a month and haven't caught up to him yet?
We managed to trail the man as far as a small Indian camp. We found it burned to the ground. Nothing was left but a few odds and ends of clothing and that remnant you're holding.
It's Cherokee work. I can't understand why anybody'd want to burn him out. They're friendly to us.
They were friendly, Mr. Boone. I visited their main village on my journey here. They blame these atrocities on the settlers. If this man isn't caught soon, I fear there'll be another Indian uprising.
You know who this man is?
His name's Benton, John Benton, a notorious criminal. Wanted for murder and for sale of powder and guns to the Indians.
Never heard of him.
Well, that's because you haven't visited the colonies lately. He's well known there, especially in taverns. He has a reputation as a drunkard and a brawler.
Well, what is it you want of me?
We've hunted this man for weeks without success. Every time we get him cornered, he vanishes without a trace. I have here a letter from the governor requesting your services. This man must be apprehended. The governor seems to feel that you're the only one who can do it.
It's very nice of the governor.
I might add there's a substantial price on Benton's head.
I won't hunt a man for money, Mr. Chadwick.
I beg your pardon. If you accept, Mr. Boone, I've been authorized to offer you whatever aid you may require. This is a matter of great urgency. If this man isn't caught soon, I fear a great many other people will be killed.
That's the crux of the matter, Mr. Chadwick. And as a matter of fact, I can't overlook a letter from the governor.
Does that mean you'll undertake it?
Well, it's not exactly the kind of hunting I prefer, but...
The governor will be very pleased. When would you care to leave?
It won't take me long to get ready.
Excellent. I'll wait for you at the inn.
Enough to teach them not to cheat an honest merchant.
An honest merchant? Hey, did you hear that, Hawks?
I heard it. Mr. Benton, you're a funny man. I'll bet 4 out of 5 of those rifles you pawned off those Indians will blow up the first time they're fired.
Make it 5 out of 5.
Hawks, you insult my business ethics. Those rifles were in excellent condition. Slightly old, perhaps, but still in good condition. Why are you coming with a sign?
It's near done.
What's that?
A clue for the authorities. How else is anybody to know who burned down this village unless I leave my name?
Just so you don't sign mine.
Hawks, you're a dishonest man. You're a criminal who refuses to be identified with his crime. That shows a lack of pride, whereas I am honest. Why should I let someone else take all the bows for my misdeeds?
If you want my opinion...
If I ever want your opinion, Pike, I'll tell you what to say.
I think you're crazy.
Genius has often been mistaken for lunacy.
It's done. How do you like it?
Oh, your printing could be better, but at least you spell my name right. All right, let's get out of here.
I can't understand why I'd want to leave his name.
It's an impertinence, Mr. Boone. This man is an unbelievable braggart. When he was in prison, he boasted that no jail could hold him. Well, apparently that's true. He now brags that no one will ever catch him. I'm beginning to think that's true, too.
Sounds like...
Oh, he is. But he's also very strong and very dangerous. They say he can bend a gun barrel with his bare hands.
Now, that's a pretty good trick.
At this point, I'd believe anything I heard about him.
Well, at least that keeps you from being taken by surprise.
Say you lost a trail around here somewhere?
Over by the stream. We found where they went in the water, but we couldn't find where they came out.
It's a cold trail. If he's as cocksure as you say he is, he might have gotten a mite careless by now.
You might catch him alone, but I doubt if you can bring him in single-handed. He's known to have at least three followers.
And where do you want him delivered?
Very well, I think Lexington would be the closest place. I'll wait for you there.
Well, give me a week. If I don't show up by then, come looking for me.
Very well. Well, goodbye, Mr. Boone.
Thank you, Mr. Chadwick.
And good luck.
Benton's everything you say is. I'll probably need it.
If I remember right, this Benton was a drinking man.
Well, you still ain't told me what you're gonna do with all this whiskey.
Well, it comes in handy for starting fires.
Now, what kind of an answer is that?
Well, it's good for snake bite, trading with the Indians.
Daniel Boone, you gonna give me a straight answer or ain't you?
Well, you know what they say about curiosity, Cincinnatus. Kill the cat.
Well, I ain't no cat.
Well, in that case, you're not in any danger.
You have been careless, Mr. Benton.
Whoever said this stuff was fit to drink?
Nobody. It was intended solely for washing purposes and for putting under bridges. Are we out of whiskey?
What do you think I'm drinking this water for?
About time we move. As soon as I can find a place we haven't been run out of.
We wait here that long, we'll...
Listen! Wake those two up, we may be in for trouble.
Sounds happy.
He sounds drunk to me.
Could be both, couldn't he?
Shut up and get behind those trees.
Somebody here? got a rifle pointed right between your eyes.
That isn't very neighborly.
It isn't meant to be. Now drop your rifle and put your pack down.
Hawks, go back down the trail and make sure he came alone.
You got some sort of suspicious nature, haven't you?
Just cautious, friend. Now, would you mind explaining what you're doing here?
Hey, be careful with that pack. I've got some wet goods in there I'd hate to get broke. Now, what was you saying?
I asked you what you were doing here.
Well, I just saw your fire from back a ways, and I figured I'd come over and be sociable.
Sort of far afield, aren't you?
Yep. I set out to sell a little whiskey to the Indians. But I found out that they're not too friendly at the moment. So I got left with all this liquor on my hands.
That is indeed a regrettable state of affairs.
I figured if I drank it all up, I wouldn't have so much to carry back. I've been working on it for quite a spell. You didn't care to join me?
I seldom touch it, but if you insist...
Not much for taste, but it's real long on authority.
I have just given a great deal of thought to the problem of lightening your load, and I believe I can suggest a solution.
About to make a speech. I would like.
Shut up. Sit down.
Yes. Shut up and sit down.
Boy, you're telling you to sit down.
I'm telling you to sit down.
Tell you to sit down.
Suppose you try and knock me down.
Suppose I do.
Suppose I do.
You'll have to forgive them, Mr. Boone. You see, they're not accustomed to drinking. Oh, well, that leaves all the more for you and me.
Thank you. all about?
I'm taking you to Lexington.
So that's how it is?
That's how it is.
You disappoint me, Mr. Boone. I would never have taken you for a bounty hunter.
I'm not.
Then what are you doing with the knife in my throat?
I'm doing the governor a little favor. Get up. Now move.
I'll go with you for a while, Mr. Boone.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. What I learned about you last night interests me. And good company around here is scarce.
Well, there's lots of fine company in Lexington.
Well, I'll be going with you, but only part way.
Move.
My head. Why don't you do me a favor and shoot me?
Don't tempt me. Move!
Chadwick, well-known bounty hunter. What are you doing way out here?
Following my calling?
You take my advice and follow someplace else. You're here when Benton gets back, he'll eat you alive.
Benton's not coming back.
What do you mean he's not coming back?
He's on his way to Lexington with Mr. Boone.
You mean Boone's a headhunter like you?
That's right.
What do you know about that? Seemed like a real nice fella, too. Well, if Benton's gone, what are you doing here?
Glad you asked me that. You see, I'm here to show you how you can make some money.
How much money?
£1,000 split among the four of us.
What do we have to do?
Just help me take Benton just before they get to Lexington. I'll take him in for the reward.
You mean Benton's worth £1,000?
He was the last time I was in the settlements.
Now, ain't that just like him? He never told us he's worth that much. If he had it, we'd have probably sold him a long time ago.
It's a bargain, then.
We'll most likely have to kill Boone in the argument.
That's one thing I insist upon.
Expecting somebody?
Your friends may have figured out what's happened.
They'd hate to lose me. You see, they've become quite successful thieves under my leadership.
It's what I've heard. Keep moving.
Don't push me too hard on this little trek or I'll call my friends in. The last time I did, they skinned the man alive. All it takes is one little yell and they'll come running.
Well, you won't be much use to them dead.
Now, would a noble type like you really shoot a man who's, tied and unarmed?
I don't rightly know for sure. Why don't you just yell and we'll both find out?
I'm not that curious just now. I'll take your suggestion and walk. I don't know about you, but I'm getting hungry.
Well, it's that time of day. Let's eat.
Aren't you gonna build a fire?
Nope. Fire wouldn't help this jerky none.
Might make it a little warmer.
Yeah, it could make things downright hot.
I guess you're referring to my friends.
Nope. They don't worry me one bit.
They worry me. They might try to rescue me before I'm ready to leave.
That's what I mean. They might have some consideration for your scalp.
There are a lot of Shawnee in these parts who might not be so particular.
I admire a cautious man.
So do I.
Enjoy yourself, just don't chew too loud.
Thank you, Mr. Boone. Mighty tasty.
Don't mention it, Mr. Benton.
I think I'll go to sleep. What are you gonna do?
Same.
Just as soon as I tie that sapling to your neck.
The old Shawnee trick. I was hoping you might not know about that.
I'll bet you were. You better pray that's not your friends. You'll be the first to go.
Yeah.
Put this knife right through you.
I'm fine! We're coming in to get you! You want to get me killed? Stay out there where you belong! I'll let you know when I'm ready to leave.
We won't never be far away.
Give me that rifle.
Can we get some sleep now?
Nope. Gonna make many more miles tonight.
If you're not careful, you'll walk me to death and you'll never get me to Lexington to hang.
Move. I don't have to remind you that these things are hair-triggered.
If I so much as sneeze, I'll get strangled.
Yeah.
How do you expect me to get any decent sleep this way?
Well, I don't. But I expect to get some.
You continue to disappoint me, Boone. When you saved me from that bear, I thought we might get to be good friends.
I might rather be friends with a bear.
You know, friend Boone, when the temperature changes at night, these things sometimes release themselves.
Yeah. I hope we don't have an early frost. Don't you?
I'm hoping. Believe me, I'm hoping.
Well, pleasant dreams.
Looks like they kept on traveling.
Yeah, reckon you yelling like that done run him off.
I told you it was a fool trick, Pike.
How else could I find out if it was Benton got shot?
Now, gentlemen, there's no need for argument. There's no harm done. Benton thinks we're here to rescue him. It'll make things a lot easier for all of us when the time comes.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking when I yelled.
You never had a thought in your life.
Well, I suggest we move on. They've got quite a lead on us.
Sleep well?
I slept like a log. How about you?
Tossed and turned all night long.
Couldn't have been the jerky.
Cut me loose from this thing, will you?
Breakfast on the way. Let's get started.
I think we're about as close to Lexington as I want to get.
Don't think you have much choice in the matter.
The rate we're traveling will be there by tomorrow. Except I guarantee we'll have parted company sometime before then.
Oh, I doubt that. Unless one of us is dead.
Well, that seems a little bit extreme. But it's a possibility.
Move.
Between here and Lexington.
There's apt to be more than enough to go around.
You sure you still want to go to Lexington? I hear New Orleans is nice this time of year.
Lexington.
Just by chance we run into more Shawnee. I hope you're planning on cutting these thongs.
I hadn't given it much thought.
Well, give it some thought. The Shawnee aren't very fond of me anyway.
Is anybody?
Now, look, I wanna... so many Shawnee in the whole territory. You must live an upright life the way the good Lord looks after you.
You better save your breath for running, Benton. Let's go. Got hit in the arm.
Well, that's one way of looking at it. Feels like there's a chip of arrowhead in there.
Want me to dig it out?
No, thanks. I figure I'm lucky to have survived your medical attention so far. Now that I've got one arm crippled, don't you think you could untie me?
Untying you the way you fight would be an injustice against the whole Shawnee Nation.
They'll be coming looking for those two.
Yeah. It's time we changed our direction.
New Orleans?
You never give up, do you?
How about by way of Boston?
You know, there's something I can't figure out about you. Our chances are slim for staying alive for the next 2 hours. And if we manage, all you've got to look forward to is getting hung. And you're still not serious about anything.
Oh, yes, I am. I'm very serious about the fact that you didn't have the foresight to bring along a jug of whiskey.
Come on.
Help me up, will you?
Thank you.
Must be getting closer. This buck ain't even stiff yet.
You don't think the Indians could have captured Boone and Benton yet, do you?
Indians never leave their dead. Sooner or later, they'll come back looking for these two.
Yeah, when they get here, I figure to be long gone.
All right, there's no time to waste. Let's move along.
Feels good. No saplings around. Maybe I'll get some sleep tonight.
I slept last night, Ben. Figure it's your turn.
That's very nice of you to feel that way, big, soft-hearted Dan Boone. When we were hiding back there, I saw you pull your knife out, and if the Shawnee got any closer, you were going to cut me loose.
Think so?
I don't think so. I know so.
What if I was going to cut your throat? That's something you'll never know.
But there's one thing I know for sure. You'll never get me to Lexington. And even with some real luck and you wouldn't take me there.
Got some real interesting ideas.
You've heard I'm bad, but you're not sure. Under the circumstances, I don't think you've got what it takes to turn me over to the hangman.
Mm-hmm. Seems like the Shawnee've got more company.
That Pike could never figure out the Indians. He probably managed to get all three of them killed.
You wouldn't be trying to throw me off guard, would you?
Why should I? They haven't been much help to me anyway.
Well, they do have some nuisance value.
Well, to a nervous man, maybe. I may have called you a lot of things, but I wouldn't call you nervous. You see, my friend, just like that old saying, if you want a thing well done, do it yourself. So now it looks like I've got to kill you. After all, me.
Benton, you talk too much. Why don't you shut up and we'll get some sleep?
It's a capital idea. This bandage is kind of tight. Fight I've had in a long time. You know, I'm beginning to like you.
Well, don't get to liking me too much. I might not live through it.
Aren't you going to pull the trigger on that thing?
Not if I can help it.
You know, you'd be better off if you go ahead and shoot me and try to get out of this mess by yourself.
Yeah, I probably would be. But I'm still going to take you to Lexington.
Just so the Shawnees don't kill me, huh?
So that no matter how you die, it won't be my responsibility.
You're wrong. Either way I die is your responsibility.
Well, so be it.
You coming to the hanging, friend Boone?
I think I ought to tell you.
not to count on me being too soft-hearted.
As can be expected, I guess.
And let's get started.
I wonder if my men are still behind me.
Last night you thought they might all be dead.
Well, only one way to find out. Pat!
Just keep quiet and get started.
As you say, friend Boone.
Get back to that rim.
You didn't have to come down here to help me, you know.
Maybe I'm getting soft-hearted. Come on. Coming up this side.
Well, that makes it unanimous. Our friends on this side are doing the same thing. Don't you think it's about time you cut me loose?
Nope.
Why not? I can't fight half as well with my hands tied.
There's too many of them for us to fight if we can help it. I think we can.
I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do that. Kentucky.
Suits me. I'm in no hurry to get to Lexington. You know, I've been thinking, I wonder how it feels at the last minute when you drop through the platform and you have a rope around your neck.
I've been doing some wondering.
About getting hung?
Not when those two Shawnees came at me. You could have let them take me.
Well, I thought about it. I figured I better clout them, or you'd shoot me first and take them on second.
I don't think I had that much time.
Well, back on the mountain there, you got me out of a pretty good fix. I reckon we were even on points. To be truthful, which I seldom am, I don't know anybody who deserves this kind of finish any more than I do. I've never done anybody any good.
It's what I hear.
But on the other hand, if I had to do it all over again, I know I'd do the same thing. I've been meaner than any 10 men, but I've had a lot more fun. Time to go.
Yeah, I reckon it is. Lexington is just over the hill.
That's a relief. I was afraid the Indians might have taken them.
I suggest you gentlemen stay out of sight until you're needed.
Mr. Boone, I commend you on a job well done.
Well, if it isn't my old friend, Mr. Chadwick.
You know him?
Oh, Mr. Benton and I are old acquaintances.
I should have killed you a long time ago.
That was your error. All right, Mr. Boone, I'll take over now.
Well, you're welcome. I never liked this from the beginning. So long, Ben.
You mean you're going to turn me over to him?
If he says so.
But you told me you weren't a bounty hunter.
Well, I'm not.
Well, Chadwick is.
That letter from the governor, Mr. Boone? My personal touch. You see, I couldn't capture Benton by myself, so it became necessary to enlist both of your services.
Hold it, Boone. You got three rifles pointed at you. Drop your gun.
Good man, Hawks. Now cut me loose so I can take care of Chadwick.
Well, now maybe I ought to explain a little.
Explain what?
See, when Chadwick there told us what you was worth.
You sold me down the river.
I should have expected so much.
It's like we've both been lied to, friend.
Does it that?
I'll take Benton in and get the money. You three can dispose of Mr. Boone.
Just a minute. How do we know you just won't keep on going?
Well, you'll just have to trust me. I'm sure you'll agree that it would be unwise for any of you to show yourselves in town.
Well, he's right about that.
We'll just keep Boone here alive till you come back. You're not here by dark. We'll turn him loose on you.
Don't you think it's about time you cut me loose? Good fight while it lasted.
Yeah. Except you finally spoiled your record.
How's that?
Finally did something for somebody else.
Who says?
You got yourself shot trying to help me.
You think I did that for you? I couldn't let them get away with double-crossing me.
I suppose you couldn't do that.
I guess I won't get hung after all.
Been tracking this character over a month and haven't caught up to him yet?
We managed to trail the man as far as a small Indian camp. We found it burned to the ground. Nothing was left but a few odds and ends of clothing and that miniature holding.
It's Cherokee work. I can't understand why anybody'd want to burn him out. They're friendly to us.
They were friendly, Mr. Boone. I visited their main village on my journey here. They blame these atrocities on the settlers. If this man isn't caught soon, I fear there'll be another Indian uprising.
You know who this man is?
His name's Benton. John Benton. A notorious criminal. Wanted for murder and for sale of powder and guns to the Indians.
Never heard of him.
Well, that's because you haven't visited the colonies lately. He's well known there, especially in taverns. He has a reputation as a drunkard and a brawler.
Well, what is it you want of me?
We've hunted this man for weeks without success.
Every time we get him cornered, he vanishes without a trace. I have here a letter from the governor requesting your services. This man must be apprehended. The governor seems to feel that you're the only one who can do it.
It's very nice of the governor.
I might add, there's a substantial price on Benton's head.
I won't hunt a man for money, Mr. Chadwick.
I beg your pardon. If you accept, Mr. Boone, I've been authorized to offer you whatever aid you may require. This is a matter of great urgency. If this man isn't caught soon, I fear a great many other people will be killed.
That's the crux of the matter, Mr. Chadwick. And as a matter of fact, I can't overlook a letter from the governor.
Does that mean you'll undertake it?
Well, it's not exactly the kind of hunting I prefer, but...
The governor will be very pleased. When would you care to leave?
It won't take me long to get ready.
Excellent. I'll wait for you at the inn.
Prime.
Enough to teach them not to cheat an honest merchant.
An honest merchant? Hey, did you hear that, Hawks?
I heard it.
Mr. Benton, you're a funny man. I'll bet 4 out of 5 of those rifles you pawned off those Indians will blow up the first time they're fired.
Make it 5 out of 5.
Hawks, you insult my business ethics. Those rifles were in excellent condition. Slightly old, perhaps, but still in good condition. Why are you coming with a sign?
It's near done.
What's that?
A clue for the authorities. How else is anybody to know who burned down this village unless I leave my name?
Just so you don't sign mine.
Hawks, you're a dishonest man. You're a criminal who refuses to be identified with his crime. That shows a lack of pride, whereas I am honest. Why should I let someone else take all the bows for my misdeeds?
If you want my opinion...
If I ever want your opinion, Pike, I'll tell you what to say.
I think you're crazy.
Genius has often been mistaken for lunacy.
It's done. How do you like it?
Oh, your printing could be better, but at least you spell my name right. All right, let's get out of here.
I can't understand why I'd want to leave his name.
It's an impertinence, Mr. Boone. This man is an unbelievable braggart. When he was in prison, he boasted that no jail could hold him. Well, apparently that's true. He now brags that no one will ever catch him. I'm beginning to think that's true, too.
Sounds like...
Oh, he is. But he's also very strong and very dangerous. They say he can bend a gun barrel with his bare hands.
Now, that's a pretty good trick.
At this point, I'd believe anything I heard about him.
Well, at least that keeps you from being taken by surprise.
Say you lost a trail around here somewhere?
Over by the stream. We found where they went in the water, but we couldn't find where they came out.
It's a cold trail. If he's as cocksure as you say he is, he might have gotten a mite careless by now.
You might catch him alone, but I doubt if you can bring him in single-handed. He's known to have at least 3 followers.
Where do you want him delivered?
Very well, I think Lexington would be the closest place. I'll wait for you there.
Give me a week. So don't show up, but then come looking for me.
Very well. Goodbye, Mr. Boone.
Thank you, Mr. Chadwick.
And good luck.
Benton's everything you say is, I'll probably need it.
If I remember right, this Benton was a drinking man.
Well, you still ain't told me what you're gonna do with all this whiskey.
Well, it comes in handy for starting fires.
Now, what kind of an answer is that?
Well, it's good for snake bite, trading with the Indians.
Daniel Boone, you gonna give me a straight answer or ain't you?
Well, you know what they say about curiosity, Cincinnatus. Kill the cat.
Well, I ain't no cat.
Well, in that case, you're not in any danger.
So you have been careless, Mr. Benton.
Whoever said this stuff was fit to drink?
Nobody. It was intended solely for washing purposes and for putting under bridges. Are we out of whiskey?
What do you think I'm drinking this water for?
About time we move. As soon as I can find a place we haven't been run out of.
We wait here that long, we'll...
Listen! Shh. Wait those two up. We may be in for trouble.
Sounds happy.
He sounds drunk to me.
Could be both, couldn't he?
Shut up and get behind those trees. Drop your rifle and put your pack down.
Hawks, go back down the trail and make sure he came alone.
You got some sort of suspicious nature, haven't you?
Just cautious, friend. Now, would you mind explaining what you're doing here?
Hey, be careful with that pack. I've got some wet goods in there I'd hate to get broke. Now, what was you saying?
I asked you what you were doing here.
Well, I just saw your fire from back a ways, and I figured I'd come over and be sociable.
Sort of far afield, aren't you?
Yep.
I set out to sell a little
whiskey to the Indians. I found out that they're not too friendly at the moment. So I got left with all this liquor on my hands.
That is indeed a regrettable state of affairs.
I figured if I drank it all up, I wouldn't have so much to carry back. I've been working over quite a spell. You didn't care to join me.
I seldom touch it, but if you insist...
It's not much for taste, but it's real long on authority.
I have just given a great deal of thought to the problem of lightening your load, and I believe I can suggest a solution.
About to make a speech. I would like...
Shut up. Sit down.
Yes, shut up and sit down.
Boy, you're telling you to sit down.
I'm telling you to sit down.
I'm telling you to sit down.
Suppose you try and knock me down.
Suppose I do.
Suppose I do.
You'll have to forgive them, Mr. Boone. You see, they're not accustomed to drinking. Oh, well, that leaves all the more for you and me.